me begin by saying a heartfelt thank you to my dedicated and hardworking campaign committee. I also want to thank the speakers here tonight who have been gracious in saying kind words about me and my potential as a senator. And most of all, I want to thank all of you for taking time to be here with me this evening. I am humbled by and grateful to you for joining me on this, my quest for a seat in the 29th Legislature of the U.S. Virgin Islands. You've already taken the first step in coming here. I hope as you listen, you will see a place for yourself in my campaign and help spread the word about me. I ask for your moral support and your ideas, essential to the growth and development of this people-powered movement. But most of all, I need your vote on primary day, Saturday, September 11th, to put me, Simon Kevin Caines, on the general election ballot. Why am I here? Putting my hat in the ring to be your senator is a natural progression for me. I was born on St. Thomas just over 37 years ago. My father, the late Arnold Caines, was born in the Dominican Republic and raised on St. Martin. And my mother, Gertrude Caines, who is here tonight, will my mother please stand? My mother was born on Nevis. And while the richness of my lineage makes me a first generation Virgin Islander, I am a Virgin Islander to the bone. It was my father's admonitions which instilled in me the pride that I have in the Virgin Islands. He would say, your mother and I are not from here, but you are. This is your home. Take ownership in it. My parents worked hard bringing up our family of six children. I am the last of those six children and the only boy to graduate high school. And the first child to finish college. I have a responsibility to do a good job by my parents and to make a contribution to my community. For more than 20 years, my commitment to public service, volunteerism, and belief that we can all work together for a better community began and continues with my relationship with the Ivana Udarkin High School. Where, as a student, I was a leader in many extracurricular activities. To ensure today's youth receive the same, if not better, educational resources, I have served on the Reaccreditation Steering Committee and now serve as the Secretary of the Alumni Association and President of my reunion class. Since receiving my bachelor's degree at Michigan State University, I have served in a variety of capacities on this island, which have influenced my decisions and shaped my opinion on what we must do to move onward and forward. Simply put, we absolutely must invest in the greatest asset of these Virgin Islands, the people of the Virgin Islands. My career has shown me the benefits of such an investment. With experiences gained during my chairmanship of Hope Inc., an AIDS education and prevention organization, my presidency of the Rotary Club of St. Thomas II, and even as my advising of the Enid M. Bach Close-Up Club, I have come to understand that the territory's most significant assets are not the tourism product, not the tax breaks we offer to its multinational corporations that come to our shores. Our most significant asset is our people. I want to work to create a system which recognizes the ideas of the people and acknowledge the key reason for developing them. There are some who say that we are living better than our foreparents, and the social and economic progress of the last 40 years has benefited all Virgin Islanders. Well, tell that to the young man who feels the educational system has failed him and finds himself with no marketable skills. Tell that to the average household householder who struggles to keep up with the ever-increasing cost of gas and electricity. And tell that to the citizens and businesses who are afraid they will not be able to meet their tax obligations. The sad part is that we haven't prepared our people to be part of the long-term and sustainable economic and social development of the territory. They have been prepared to be consumers, not producers. We must change that. I am running to be your senator in the 29th legislature because I want to keep to help develop the full potential of every Virgin Islander as the key to our long-term economic and social progress. I want to put our people, our society, our economic needs at the front and center of our government. We must invest in our youth through education and training and provide the foundation necessary to keep more of them away from a life of crime. We must explore opportunities to create jobs and generate revenue for the territory and improve our quality of life through development of agricultural and healthcare industries and by lowering our energy costs. It is time for us to ask and answer tough questions. Has our community done well by the program of economic development that we have followed over the last 40 years? Not always. Are there better alternatives more suitable to the realities of the 21st century? Yes. Can we work collectively to improve our current situation? Emphatically, yes. As your senator, I pledge to work to create meaningful solutions to ensure the future of the Virgin Islands. My platform that we've shared with you tonight highlights youth and education, jobs, healthcare, public safety, agriculture, government reform as the critical issues of the day. These areas must get the attention they deserve if we are serious about turning this territory around. My plans are ambitious. We have a 16-page platform, but I believe that my proven record of leadership and service to this community makes me the right person to tackle these ambitious issues. Great things can be accomplished if we put our collective heads together to make the Virgin Islands a better place for all. Government must make a commitment to invest in the minds, in the bodies, in the health, ideas, talents, and the skills of the people. You will note that I haven't said much about the crime, which is our biggest problem today. I believe that the investment in the people of the Virgin Islands will bring about the solutions to the crime. No amount of arrests, no amount of prisons will curb our plight with respect to crime. With your support and your vote, I commit to investing in our greatest asset, you, our people, and working to make sure the Virgin Islands is a place that once again cares about the people of the Virgin Islands. We must invest in us. If you think investing in our human capital is the key to our long-term economic and social progress, join our movement. So, if you believe, as I do, that our greatest asset is our people, please go out on primary day, Saturday, September 11th, and vote for me, Simon Kevin Caines. The time is now. Thank you very much. As I said earlier, we have a very detailed platform. I went against conventional wisdom because there are some that told me, listen, Virgin Islanders just don't read. If you give them this thing, they're just going to throw it on the ground and they really won't read it. But I believe, as I go about the territory talking to people every day, St. John, St. Thomas, Water Island, I talk to people every day, they want change. They want people who have integrity, they want people who have ethics. They want people who have vision. I believe that all of those things are expressed in my platform, and I ask you to read it. My telephone number is a part of the document. Call me, share your ideas, share your thoughts, because the only way that we're gonna get there is together. So once again, thank you for being here. I appreciate your support, and look forward to meeting and talking with you all along the campaign trail. Have a great night.